We have written 5 letters to Oyetola, the new governor, that let's go and let's talk, let's deliberate on the EU. He didn't answer us. And we believe that, let us tell the whole world that this is what is going on in Osun State. We have been suffering, people have been dying, people cannot pay the school fees of their children. Many of us have died. Many of us are bedridden right now. There was a woman, he was amputated 2 weeks ago because of diabetes. If it had been paid, it might have taken care of herself.
The state collected a parish foreign refund, which is not true. That is the cause of the aggression. And then we are going to clarify to them that the state did not receive any Paris fund refund. The government has tried. We've been paying their pension along salary and regularly and in full of recent, and we intend to continue that way. That's the intention, and we are working assiduously to ensure that this is sustained, and we also ensure that their gratuity that is in the arrears have been paid. We've been paying 100,000 for each of them every year, every month, and we have agreed to increase to 200,000 so that when we have funds, it can be meaningful to them. And this is our promise and pledge. So, we should go home.
As you are saying, you are paying full pension and salary. It's not. Payment of monthly pension, when the next month is mature for payment, it's not monthly, it is related to payment of our pension. So, pay our monthly pension when it is matured. Like I was saying in Rave, you paid every separate pension and salary on the 23rd of May. That May was paid close to 20 or 21 of June. So, economic situation in the state, in the country, is bad. And I want to tell you, Deputy, the main strength of our economy in Osun State is salary and pension.